Given the function f of x equals 2x squared minus 18, we want to find the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry. We want to find the coordinates of the vertex, the x-intercepts, and the y-intercept, and then finally graph the function. So let's start with a quick review. The graph of a quadratic function, as we see here in blue, is a parabola. This green vertical line is called the axis of symmetry. It always has the equation x equals negative b over 2a. The vertex is the only point that's on the axis of symmetry and the parabola, this point here. And since it's on the axis of symmetry, the x-coordinate is always going to be negative b all over 2a, and the y-coordinate is the function value when x is equal to negative b over 2a. The points where the graph crosses the x-axis are the x-intercepts. Notice the x-intercepts always have a y-coordinate equal to 0. And where the graph crosses the y-axis is the y-intercept. Notice any point on the y-axis would have an x-coordinate equal to 0. Now let's go back to our function and find all of these components. We'll start by finding the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, which again is given by this formula here. So looking at our function, we should recognize that a is going to be equal to positive 2. B is the coefficient of the x term. There is no x term, so b is equal to 0. C is the constant term, so in this case c is equal to negative 18 because it's minus 18. So for the equation of the axis, we're going to have x equals, well, this would just be negative 0 all over 2 times 2, which is going to be 0 over 4, which is equal to 0. So the equation of our axis of symmetry is x equals 0, which would be the y-axis. Next, in order to find the vertex, remember the vertex is on the axis of symmetry, so the x-coordinate of the vertex would have to be 0. And then to find the y-coordinate, we need to find f of 0. Well, f of 0 is just going to be 2 times 0 squared minus 18. This is going to be 0 minus 18, or negative 18. So our vertex has coordinates 0, comma, negative 18. Next, we want to find the x-intercepts. Remember, all the points on the x-axis have a y-coordinate of 0. So to find the x-intercepts, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Remember, the function values are y values. So to find the x-intercepts, we want to solve the equation 0 equals 2x squared minus 18. Let's see if we can solve this by factoring. Remember, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor, which in this case is 2, leaving us with x squared minus 9, which is a difference of squares. So we have 0 equals 2. This is going to factor into two binomial factors, x, and then 9 is a perfect square because it's equal to 3 times 3. One factor has a sum, one factor has a difference. So our solutions here are x equals negative 3 or x equals positive 3. Remember, we're looking for the values of x that make these factors equal to 0, so this product is equal to 0. So there are two main ways to give the x-intercepts. I like giving them as ordered pairs to emphasize that they are points. So one point would have coordinates negative 3, comma 0. The other x-intercept would have coordinates 3, comma 0. Or if we wanted to, we could say the x-intercepts equal negative 3 and positive 3. What we don't want to do, though, is leave the x-intercepts in the form of x equals negative 3 or x equals positive 3, because these two equations here actually represent vertical lines, not points on a graph. And then for the last part, we want to find the y-intercept, and because every point on the y-axis has an x-coordinate of 0, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y, which in this case we already did when we found the vertex, because remember, if we have f of x equals 2x squared minus 18, this is equivalent to y equals 2x squared minus 18. We replace x with 0. Notice how we have negative 18, and that's because our y-intercept is the point 0, comma, negative 18. So in this case, the vertex and the y-intercept are the same, but of course that's not always the case. And we can also write this as the y-intercept equals negative 18. But again, we don't want to communicate the y-intercept by saying y equals negative 18, because technically that would be a horizontal line. Now let's go ahead and put all these pieces together to graph our function. We'll start by sketching the axis of symmetry, which has the equation x equals 0, which should be the y-axis. The vertex has coordinates 0, negative 18, which remember in this case is also our y-intercept. And the x-intercepts are negative 3 and positive 3, so the parabola passes through this point here and this point here. With these three key points, we can make a pretty good graph of our function. It'll look something like this. And I also graphed this using a program called WinPlot, which we can see looks just like our graph, and we can also use this graph to verify our work. I hope you found this helpful.